This video is made possible by Audible. Get a free audiobook of your choice from Audible exclusively by going to audible.com/reallifelore in the description. There are countless stars in the universe. There may be around 100 billion stars just in our Milky Way galaxy alone, but the single strangest one that we've discovered so far is a pretty close one to home. Known officially as KIC 8462852, it's only a little larger than the Sun is and is only located about 1,280 light years away from us. It's been known to humanity for quite some time, but always remained relatively obscure until recent observations noticed something strange back in 2015. It seemed like KIC 8462852 was getting dimmer, and nobody really understood why. Researchers became aware in 2015 that back in March of 2011, recordings made by the Kepler Space Telescope indicated that the star's brightness was reduced by up to 15%, and by February 2013, its brightness had been reduced by up to 22%. The star continued to dim and brighten again, which suggested that something enormous was orbiting around it. For comparison, a planet the size of Jupiter would only obscure the star by just 1%. This indicated that whatever was blocking the light from the star wasn't a planet, but something way bigger, covering up to half of the entire width of the star. In addition to these day-long dimmings and brightenings, a study of a century's worth of photographic plates dating between 1890 and 1998 suggested that the star's brightness had gradually faded by 20% in that time, an amount unprecedented by any other known star of this size and type. Speculation began to run rampant about what was causing the star to fade, and one of the more interesting theories was that we were witnessing the construction of a giant alien megastructure called a Dyson sphere. In a paper written back in 1960 by Freeman Dyson titled Search for Artificial Stellar Sources of Infrared Radiation, Dyson suggested that any other technological civilization in the universe would likely follow a similar power consumption pattern to that of humans. Since humanity's energy needs have been continuously growing year by year, it's possible that eventually we'll need more energy than what we can produce on Earth. So, the logical end step for maximum energy harvesting is to harvest it directly from the Sun from one of three different types of Dyson spheres. Type 1 is to build a ring of orbiting structures around the star that collect light and wirelessly transfer the energy back to the home planet. A Type 2 is to build a bubble of satellites around the star that absorbs a good percentage of the light, but not all of it. And a Type 3 is to completely swallow the star with a solid shell of matter that absorbs 100% of the energy and light that the star produces. If a sphere like this was built around the Sun with a radius of 1 AU, the sphere's surface area would be 550 million times the surface area of Earth, and it would produce a ridiculous 384.6 yottawatts of energy, about 33 trillion times the entire energy consumption of all of humanity in 1998. Access to such an enormous amount of energy would essentially make any civilization that harnessed it appear to us to be as powerful as gods. We don't know what exactly would be possible. It would kind of be like showing Paleolithic people what a nuclear reactor would be capable of doing. Freeman Dyson speculated that any civilization in space that got advanced enough would eventually build one of these types of structures, which meant that in theory, we could detect their presence by observing a massive dip in light, sort of like what was happening with KIC 8462852. However, Dyson also believed that most known substances that would make up a Dyson sphere would be re-radiating energy in the infrared part of the electromagnetic spectrum, which was not being detected with our mysterious star. In 2016, the lead researcher into the light irregularities of the star said in a now famous TED talk that, "Extraordinary claims require extraordinary evidence, and it is my job, my responsibility, as an astronomer to remind people that alien hypotheses should always be a last resort." To further add to the mystery, though, the SETI Institute concluded that whatever material is blocking the light between us and the star is located inside the star's habitable zone, where life like ours would be possible. The craziest theory is that we may be currently observing a gigantic interplanetary space battle that included the apocalyptic destruction of a planet that generated dust obscuring the light from the star. Seriously, all natural explanations were turning up weak, until a recent study was concluded just last month in January 2018. More than 1,700 people donated over $100,000 to fund the study, which concluded that the most likely culprit blocking the star's light was just dust. The data showed that different colors of light were being blocked at different intensities, which meant that whatever is passing between us and the star isn't opaque, which is what would be expected from either a planet or an alien megastructure. If it is dust, though, it's still not entirely clear why that much would be in the system, though, in the first place, considering that it doesn't appear to be a young star system. Dust should have coalesced into a series of planets by now, which is yet another part of the puzzle surrounding KIC-8462852. There is still work that needs to be done in finding answers out about this star. We still can't say for certain what exactly is going on, but what I can say for certain is how to get a free audiobook. You head over to audible.com/reallifelore. As I'm sure you've heard before, Audible is a leading provider of audiobooks and other spoken word entertainment. They have thousands of amazing titles, and there are some audiobooks that you can only find on Audible, like Artemis by Andy Weir, a story that takes place in a city on the moon in humanity's near future written by the author of The Martian, which I strongly recommend. What's amazing to me about Audible, though, is that they stand behind their product. If you don't like what you've listened to, you can swap it out for another one with their Great Listen Guarantee. Once you try out your free book, membership includes one free title each month and 30% off everything else. I love listening to audiobooks while I'm driving or exercising, and I'm sure you will too, so it's worth going and trying out a book for free with their 30-day free trial at audible.com/reallifelore.